have you with David. David is from Namibia, Africa. David is one of the 2015 selected candidates of Mandela Washington Fellows. And Mandela Washington Fellows is a flagship program of Young African Initiative. That is a program that is effort, that has the effort of President Barack Obama, who decided that his administration has to invest in the next generation of African leaders. Now, welcome, David.
Thank you very much.
You are in US for a huge movement. Like, I looked over the internet, YALEP program is everywhere, and there are a lot of young people out there trying to be in these kind of things. But we want to know how you got started and what made you selected for such a great program.
Right. As you have said, my name is Sebolon David. I'm from Namibia. I'm a technology entrepreneur. What I do is that we own an organization that's providing practical training to jobless graduates who do not have employment, and we are giving them practical skills in computer science and software engineering. Basically, what we are doing is we take these graduates, we put them in a program, and then we give them we put them in a bootcamp program that's giving them practical skills, and they become employable or get to start their own businesses.
Wow, that's great. Back time when I was in Africa, there used to be a saying that the rich grow richer, the poor grow poorer. What inspired you to try to help people who are jobless?
Right. In the past, I've worked for the University of Namibia as a computer science lecturer. And one thing I've realized is that we had more people graduating and they go out there and look for jobs, and then they don't get employment, and some of them actually get to do other jobs that they have not studied for out of their fields actually. And that prompted me to actually resign my work and to go back to my community and start my company to help out the graduates and the school dropouts who do not have employment.
This is an impact. You're impacting a lot of people out there, and this is a very great movement. So in terms of helping people, how did you select those people who are jobless? You go out and just pick people on the street? Because I believe that you want to always help those who are looking for help. Because if you help people who don't need help, you always help them for the rest of your life. So how is this selection?
Right. What we actually do is that we look for passionate people, people who are willing to change their lives. Because one, we believe that a person needs to be willing to change their lives first before they can be advised to change or to improve their lives. So what we basically do is that we call on to the community, the people that are willing to change their life or to leave the bad things, and then we kind of put them in a program where we mentor them and we kind of give them information on the various options that are out there.
What you do, is it something that you have always wanted to do, or is it something that as you grew older, you decided that I just want to do this?
I have a very tough background. I grew up from a low middle class family. I grew up selling sugar canes actually to pay for my school fees, and we worked very hard actually to pass our grade 12s, our high school. And after passing high school, I went to the university. I did 2 years of civil engineering, and then I had gotten a scholarship to go and study in a foreign country. But then upon arrival, I was put actually in a kindergarten, and we were made to study with the kids. And that actually opened my mind, and then made me think that, realize that there's so many people out there in my country that needs a lot of help. Regardless whether it's a university graduate or somebody who have dropped out of school, people deserve a second opportunity.
Now, you are one of these kind of people that I've always wanted to ask this thing. I want to get this. Now, you work with people who are jobless. I'm really sure you've talked with a lot of them. What are some of those things that a lot of them are facing in your country?
Most of the people that, a lot of young people out there in my country, who are jobless is that, one, they want to get things easier. They want to take the easier routes because they think people get things free. They think they deserve to be helped and so on. But one of the most important things that I tell young people out there is that they have to work for themselves. They have to stand up and be willing to work for themselves, and nobody can tell them what to do. Their parents have done a lot of things, raising them And that was enough for them to realize that there is a lot that can be done. And there's so much actually in the society to guide people. Let's say, for example, looking at a seed. A seed starts, you know, it's a small, tiny thing, and then you plant it, you have to water it, and then it grows, it generates, and then to the becoming a tree and the fruits come. Those are signs in nature that are supposed to give evidence or to give signs of how we are supposed to live our lives and change and improve our lives.
That really resonated with me because I have a lot of friends who I went back in high school with them, and I always tell them that we were born in the story of our parents, but how we live the rest of our life is based on us. Because a lot of people in Africa, they grow, they believe that their parents need to always show them the way, take them, they give them the connection. But I believe it starts with you as a person. How bad do you want it? There's a favorite quote by one of my mentors, Eric Thomas, that say, you gotta want success as bad as you wanna breathe. But in terms of you dealing with all these people who are jobless, when you guys are helping them, do you help them to what level? Like, you give them jobs and just keep helping them, or it gets to a level and you say, now you gotta be on your own or something?
What we're basically doing is we are providing employable skills. We are giving them courses, short courses, in programming. We are training them how to run a business, how to start a business, what it takes to start a business and growing a business. And we are also giving them general education development courses, like, for example, English, mathematics, and so on. So we are not only basically focusing one group, people who can read already, but we have one of the core people that we have in our group is people who are deaf, people with disabilities, and we are creating this environment that is very inclusive in the sense that we don't want to leave anybody behind. So basically what we intend to do is that to create an ecosystem, a technology ecosystem that is conducive for young entrepreneurs and the startups to grow and to be able to survive.
Oh, wow, that's really good. You know, I believe that also a lot of young people in your country that has ideas like you, that have things they want to create, and some die with the idea inside them. Sometimes the major problem is getting the team, getting those people to believe in your ideas, getting those people to work with. Now, what are some of the things that you've learned from building your own team and you run a big successful business? Now, what are some of the things that you learned from building a great team?
One thing that I've realized as I was building this team is that I've gone through a lot of things, really. I've taken people from the street and then they would steal my things. I'll come and then the computers are gone. I'll take people and then I come and then they've broken computers for the clients, for example, and so forth. So we have gone through a lot of things. One thing I've learned is that all these things, they seem to be failures, but they are actually lessons that you can learn from. And people are different, and you need to identify the talents from the people. You need to listen, and when you listen more, then you get the answers from the people. Because then, when you establish a very good communication channel between you and the team, you just prosper. You just get to grow.
That is not only a business skill, that is more of like an inspiration right now, because it really makes a lot of sense. And who are some of your mentors that you listen to them, or you hear what they say and put them into action?
Right, my best mentor is my mom. Like I said earlier, we grew up selling sugar canes, and she taught us the very basic things of running a business. You go out there, you're carrying a bunch of sugar canes, and if you are not selling, you end up carrying the bunch of sugar canes the whole day. So you need to make sure that you sell so that the burden becomes lighter. And those are some of the teachings that we have learned, that the more the harder you work, the more you work hard, the lighter the burdens become of life.
That is really great. You know, if I was you, if they put me in a place, I'm going to write a book that from selling sugar cane to running a business. You know, there are a lot of young people in Africa, when you travel there, they sell sugar cane on the street, they sell different things. And some believe that life It's not, they believe that I was born in an environment that people did not make it to the top, so I can't really do it. So, but you represent one of those people who left from that bottom and decided that I'm going to grow and help other people become what they really want to do. And I really love what you do. And how can young people, or people who are jobless, or people who know people who are jobless in your country, want to be part of what you do, or want to support, like, hey, I've been thinking about this, I want to support this guy, I want to support what you do. How can they do that?
One thing that I can say is that we need to look into the issue of everybody contributing to the effort of making a change. We need to think big, but then we need to be able to break down our big ideas into smaller chunks that we can manage. And the more achievements these little achievements that we achieve, are the ones that will motivate us to work hard, actually, towards our bigger goals and vision. So what I tell people, especially young Africans, is that there's a traditional food that we have in my country. We call it Oshifima. And one thing that I've learned from the very young age is that we don't eat the whole Oshifima at once. We break it down. You take a piece and then you dip it in the sauce and then you eat. And some of these techniques are the things that we are using in business. So basically what I'm saying is that there's so much that we have in Africa that we've been taught from our roots that we can still apply in running a business and growing our organizations to higher levels.
That is really great. You know, I have a background in civil engineering as well, and something I learned from civil engineering is there is no mansion, there is no big building that have ever been constructed without a foundation. So what you're trying to really say is you put a brick after a brick after a brick, and before you realize it, you have a mansion.
Right.
So, but young people fail to really understand that, and I really thank you for having this mindset and creating a platform that continues to support people who have a passion, but maybe because of something. And how can people now learn more about what you do and maybe be part of it?
Right, I can be reached on my email. My email is munteco@gmail.com, and I can also be reached in social media, especially Twitter
and Facebook, by my hashtag NHIX_M, that is Sebulon David.
That sounds good. Can you just share us one little thing you learning in the United States that you plan on having it as a plan of action when you go back home?
One thing that I've learned
In the United States is that I've learned that we have big ideas in Africa. We have all these innovative ideas, but then we need to break it down. We need to break them down and prioritize on what we can start first and what follows until we get to where we get to reach our goals.
That sounds good. Now, viewers, you've been listening to somebody who decided that I'm not going to work for a living, but I'm going to leave my making. This seem as this kind of people. You have something special. You shared a lot of brilliant things about what you guys are doing in Africa to change a lot of things that are going on around and develop a whole nation. How can people find out and learn more about what you do?
Right.
We can be reached at Tate Institute of Technology on the social medias like Facebook, Twitter, as well as the LinkedIn, or search me personally, Sebulon David, on the Facebook page.
That sounds really good. You've learned about how you can find them. They're everywhere on social media, and I believe that once you put your name, you'll be able to learn more about what they do. Thank you so much, David.
Thank you very much.